नेक्स्ट ड्रग इज अमीनोग्लाइकोसाइड एंटीबायोटिक. द ड्रग नेम्स एंड्स विद माइसिन और मिसिन. वाई द डिफरेंस? बिकॉज दे आर ऑब्टेंड फ्रॉम टू डिफरेंट माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म. इफ द ड्रग नेम एंड्स विद माइसिन इट इज ऑब्टेंड फ्रॉम स्ट्रेप्टोमाइसिस एंड इफ इट एंड्स विद मिसिन इट इज ऑब्टेंड फ्रॉम माइक्रो मोनोस्पोरा. इट इज बैक्टीरियाजाइडल अदर नॉट लाइक अदर drugs which inhibits bacterial protein synthesis. Already you have seen the chart. It is bactericidal because it causes leakage of cell membrane. It is introduced in 1944 by Waksman. It was a great work he has done to identify a drug which is highly effective and is gram negative, but didn't gain any importance. But he gained much importance because it was found to be very much effective against TB. And the drug gained much importance. Streptomycin is effective for tuberculosis. Classification, simple classification. Systemically administered drugs like streptomycin, I pronounce gentamicin to remember the name, tobramycin, amikacin, natalmycin, paromomycin. Only topically used neomycin and framycin because of their high auto and nephrotoxicity. Auto features. They all are polar compounds, means they are highly water soluble in nature, and so they are not orally absorbed. They are either given only intramuscularly or intravenously because they are not orally absorbed because they are highly water soluble. They do not cross blood-brain barrier because again they are highly water soluble. They are distributed extracellularly only. They do not enter the human cells because again they are highly water soluble. They are excreted by glomerular filtration because of their small molecular size and high water solubility. They are bactericidal in nature compared to other drugs which inhibits bacterial protein synthesis. They show a narrow therapeutic index. Remember, therapeutic index LD50 by ED50. Therapeutic index should be always greater than 1 for a drug to be safe. They loses their activity under low pH, presence of bivalent cation and the absence of oxygen. So the lack of oxygen shows that they are completely ineffective against anaerobic microorganisms. They are active only against aerobic microorganism, and the gram-negative organisms are more sensitive. They show post-antibiotic effect. Post-antibiotic effect means even if the drug is withdrawn, the inhibitory effect on the growth of microorganism remains for more than 1 week. Almost all the drugs shows 3 main toxicity. One is ototoxicity, that is toxicity to the ear, nephrotoxicity and neuromuscular blockade resulting in skeletal muscle weakness, which is more observed in patients with myasthenia gravis. They accumulate in endolymph, perilymph and renal cortex in large amount. That may be also the reasons for the above side effect. It shows synergism with the beta-lactam antibiotic because these drugs affect the cell membrane while beta-lactam antibiotic affect the cell wall. So both are affected, so they show synergism with the beta-lactam antibiotics. And they develop resistance by some microorganisms which produce enzymes like acetylate, adenylate, phosphorylase, etc. Example, Salmonella. Coming to mechanism of action, the heading is absent. I repeat, it's a mechanism of action. They binds irreversibly to 30S ribosomal subunit or at 50S or at the interface of 50 or 30S ribosomal subunit, resulting in misreading of the mRNA codon. Misreading of the mRNA codon means instead of reading the correct triplet codon, they may read a wrong triplet codon. That may result in introduction of a wrong amino acid into the peptide chain. and they can also cause premature termination of protein synthesis, and all these give rise to multi non-functional and abnormal proteins which may incorporate into the cytoplasmic membrane, leading to loss of semi-permeable nature of the cell membrane and disruption of the cell membrane, leading to leakage of the vital water-soluble substances, disruption of the normal functions because of the abnormal proteins, and finally leading to a bactericidal effect. Adverse effects. The main side effect, always remember kindly aminoglycoside. Wherever you hear the side effect is ototoxicity, OTO, both vestibular and cochlear toxicity. They will affect the hearing. There will be progressive hearing loss and vestibular toxicity leading to affecting the balancing, resulting in vertigo, ataxia, etc. The reason is damage to the 8th cranial nerve. Second is nephrotoxicity. This is also important. Usually it is reversible. Third is neuromuscular blockade, which is more important in patients with myasthenia gravis because already their skeletal muscles are weak. And the diaphragm, which is a skeletal muscle, so diaphragm will again relax. So that can affect the respiration of the patient. So it is more dangerous in patients with myasthenia gravis. Scotoma. That is simply we can call enlargement of the blind spot, resulting in a vision like what is shown in the figure. Peripheral neuritis, pain and irritation at the site of injection. Hypersensitivity is also observed, but not anaphylaxis. Indications, they're mainly used for treating gram-negative infections like infection by E. coli, Proteus causing UTI, abdominal sepsis, mainly uses gentamicin. Second is Klebsiella pneumonia, uses gentamicin. Pseudomonas infections like respiratory tract or septic arthritis, again gentamicin is the drug of choice. Tuberculosis, streptomycin is the drug of choice, kindly remember. Tularemia and plague, again streptomycin is the drug of choice. Bacterial endocarditis, already I mentioned it is difficult to treat because of lack of rich blood supply. So the combination of aminoglycoside and beta-lacto antibiotic gives good synergism and can be effective for treating bacterial endocarditis. Natalizumab, it is a reserve drug for serious infection, only for resistant cases. Neomycin, it is not orally absorbed, mainly used topically, but it can be used orally for the preparation of bowel for surgery for reducing the bacterial load because it is not absorbed orally. It can be topically used for wounds, burn injuries, ulcers, conjunctivitis, ophthalmia, neonatorum. You might have heard neosporin powder. It is neomycin only. Fromicetin, not at all used orally because it is absorbed to some extent. It is only used topically for skin, eye and ear infection. Precautions while taking aminoglycoside, it is phytotoxic, so avoid during pregnancy. It is show ototoxicity and nephrotoxicity, so has to be careful with that. Kidney function has to be monitored because it's nephrotoxicity, and the drug should be avoided if the patient is taking any drug which causes auto or nephrotoxicity. Muscle weakness, already I mentioned myasthenia gravis. Thank you.